animals into a computer, which they did a monkey. 2045.com, look it up. So the monkey's in the computer, his mind is, but the body's dead. Then by 2010 or 2012, they were supposed to have been able to transfer a human consciousness into a robot. They've already done that. And United States as well. DARPA has a project called the Avatar Project. And in the Avatar Project, they have a symbiotic link from a soldier underneath a mountain somewhere, like in a bunker, connected to a field robot. And it controls it through a mind connection. If the robot is destroyed, of course, the soldier doesn't die. And the only thing that stopped us from transferring consciousness from one brain to another was data storage. Now we have that solved because Microsoft just came up with the first DNA hard drive. That hard drive can store over 433 petabytes of data. That's on 1 gram of DNA. It's a drop of DNA.
Most Christian Zionists in America have no idea that the people living in Israel are not native. The area of Palestine, Israel, whatever you want to call it, they were not born there. They immigrated from Europe.
Ashkenazi Jews.
They were Ashkenazi Jews who came in from Europe and with the rifle took the land. God didn't give it to them. They took it at the point of a rifle shooting Arabs, and they killed Muslims and Christians. They slaughtered them, massacres. Women, children, horrible massacres. That is the history of Israel, 1948. And I dare any Christian Zionist to prove me wrong, because I can show you the historical records of the massacres that took place in 48. It was horrible, absolutely horrible, the people who were killed. And because of that, the Arabs developed a fury, an anger that European Ashkenazis just flooded in to Palestine and violently pushed them off their land.
So I want to remind you again, the United States government has never, out of all the money they have spent, has never ever built bunkers for the people of this country. They have their bunkers, and they spend our money to build them, but they didn't build us one. And World War III is about to kick off, if you didn't notice. Everybody on the planet is gearing up for war, and the shit's about to fly. We don't have anywhere to run, folks, and they want us to fight the war for them while they run in their bunkers and hide. I say send a pipeline of water and smoke into those goddamn bunkers and bring those little rat bastards up out of there so they can join in the fucking fun they're leaving for all of us.
There is a good chance that these people are not getting on planes and that they're actually going underground. This is very, very scary.
This is fucking ridiculous, son.
America, there are 80 million people with a record. 80 million, that's more than the population of Canada, right? And 9 out of 10 of those folks already served our time. They're like us. We're mothers, fathers. Mm-hmm. We ain't committed no crimes. We're not criminals. Mm-hmm. We just broke the law a while ago. Mm-hmm. My crime was...
We was young and didn't know no better.
Exactly. I was 18, fresh out of high school, mm-hmm. right? The problem with having a record in America is you face what is called collateral consequences. Mm-hmm. Legal restrictions that kick in after you serve your time. Mm-hmm. These are 40,000 of these things. Half of them are employment related and lock people out of entire industries, healthcare, insurance, government, education. You can't work in if you have a felony. Mm-hmm. So you're locked out of society and you can't rent anywhere. You literally can't rent in places in Midtown or Uptown because they run background checks. Mm-hmm. And it causes what is called post-conviction poverty all around the country. So when you see people around here walking down the streets, homeless, addicted, and they're like, and we're all like, what happened? At some moment in time, they broke the law and they couldn't get back on their feet.
This is not a church.
It was never a church. And if you give me 3 minutes, I'm going to absolutely turn your world upside down and blow your mind. You may have heard about a strange story going around that we were a part of an advanced civilization that fell apart due to some kind of invasion. And that incredible buildings like these, surrounded by all these smaller buildings, are actually part of two completely different worlds and times. If you're under the impression that structures like these can be built in our modern times, think again, because they can't, and they haven't been for hundreds of years. There are countless buildings like this scattered all over the world that we repurposed as banks, churches, universities, and state buildings. You'll also notice that a lot of these buildings have the word founded etched in the side instead of built. That's because we found them. We didn't make them. So let's talk about what these buildings were really used for before we repurposed them. It's becoming painfully obvious that our religions and our religious institutions do not serve us and, in fact, were built to control us. We're starting to realize that many of the stories we've been told about our religions have been twisted and corrupted to imprison our minds and our spirits. Well, it gets so much crazier and worse than that. Because these buildings were never churches. They were healing centers and amplification centers for our meditation and prayers to make our thoughts reality, word to flesh. The painted glass windows and all the geometric shapes were meant to amplify those frequencies outward and inward to heal us and create a protective force field around the building and around the empire. Going back to this picture, you see that circle right there? That's cymatics. Just go look up a video where they play sounds on sand and then the sand takes different shapes. It looks exactly the same as that. This architecture is a frozen masterpiece of music, which caused frequencies to emanate within and without to have all sorts of amazing and powerful effects. Yes, all the old stories of Atlantis and Tartaria are absolutely true, and you can see the evidence of it just by going to one of these churches. But it gets even crazier than that. Look at the domes here. Look at those little circular balls. These are conductors, okay? We don't have a cross or the moon and the star here, and there's a good reason why. I'm just going to put this ugly modern church in the background while we talk about this so this can really sink in for you. All of our religious symbols like crosses and moons and stars were actually just carefully crafted antenna. They were shaped that way to pull energy into the building. And now just think about how you have defined your entire life based on these symbols. Defended them, fought other people over them, thought you were worshiping a god through that symbol. They are laughing in our face. And guess what? It gets even crazier in part two when we talk about the Oregon Generator. Welcome to part two of A Church is Not a Church, and it never was. Every single old world church that you've ever walked into was not a church. It was just repurposed to appear as a church. Like this incredible masterpiece, St. Peter's Basilica. Why don't we build buildings like this anymore? Really ask yourself this. Anyway, in part one, we explained how all of these old world churches were actually healing centers and amplification centers for the free energy that we use to pull from the atmosphere and from the spiritual realm. We basically figured out zero-point energy, and this is why Atlantis and Tartaria were so powerful. In this video, we're going to be focusing on one small piece of this technology inside of these buildings, and that is the confessional box. The confessional box was not for you to confess your sins. The confessional box was meant to heal you. That's because it was an Oregon generator. If you don't know what Oregon is, make sure you look this up afterwards and look at Wilhelm Reich and all of his work with Oregon energy. Just to help you understand this, this is kind of your run-of-the-mill confessional box. And this is an Oregon generator. Notice the similarities? So this is a basic schematic of an Oregon generator box. Notice you have the steel and wool layers, right? The steel is a conductor. The wool sort of creates that static electricity atmosphere, so it keeps charging it up more and more. Then you have your insulation layers that are dielectric, which I believe means it'll insulate so it doesn't escape, but it'll help to compound it as it moves inward toward the middle of the box. What happens once this energy gets into the middle of the box is you have condensed Holy Spirit, condensed chi. People would go into these boxes with illnesses, and they'd walk out without any illness. They were very powerful and would sometimes cause you to go into, like, toxosis, but it was only because it was cleaning you out completely. Just to help this sink in, this is a modern church. Compare that to all the other pictures I've shown you in part one and part two. We have no idea how to build these buildings anymore. We don't even know who built them exactly or how they did it. Okay, so if you go to the Alamo, that's in Texas, right? There is a church on the grounds. By the way, this place was also invaded by the Europeans and taken away from the indigenous population. They've turned the inside of the church into a museum. And there's a little display center for the confessional box. There it explains that they found copper leaf inside of the confessional box. And copper is highly conductive. The outside was wood, the insulator. These goofballs stumbled on these buildings and didn't know what to think. Imagine if human beings eventually hopped in their spaceships and we got to another solar system and came across a planet where there used to be an advanced alien species. Their technology wouldn't even make sense, but we'd try to use it and we'd repurpose it in ways that would be useful to us, but it would never be at their level. This is essentially what happened with us. How the heck it all happened, I'm not sure. But
do you know what I love about empaths? They already know. They already know. The moment you're plotting, you're planning, you're not being genuine, you're manipulating, you have an agenda, we already know. But we enjoy the ride. We give you an opportunity to heal from your bullshit. We show you the example of what you need to do. Now, if you don't follow it, that's up to you. You reap what you sow. Don't be dead.
Look at Blue Scanlon's ass. Now, I put that food out there for this little cat. Blue's food. 3 bowls. But you outside eating that outside cat food. Look, got that cat walking away. I know, honey. When he leave, I'm going to put some more out there. Because he's just fat and greedy. Blue, leave that cat food alone. Blue. 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 Blue, leave that. He eating all the little ones he want. That nigga scandalous, bro. Just like a nigga, just eat all the food. Look, she over there waiting. I know. Look, Blue, get your butt in here now, Blue, Blue, Blue. Blue. Hey, you don't listen. Look, and where he go? Like, you just fat. For no reason. Look at Blue Scanlon's ass. Now, I put that food out there for this little cat. Blue's food. 3 bowls. But you outside eating that outside cat food. Look, got that cat walking away. I know, honey. When he leave, I'm going to put some more out there. Because he's just fat and greedy. Blue, leave that cat food alone. Blue. 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 Blue, 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 leave that, he eating all the little ones he want. That nigga scandalous, bro, just like a nigga, just eat the food. Look, she over there waiting, I know. Look, Blue. Get your butt in here now. Blue. 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 Hey, you don't listen. Look, and where he go? Like, you just fat. For no reason.
Baby, you understand me now. If sometimes you see that I'm mad, don't you know no one alive can always be an angel? When everything goes wrong, you see some bad. But I'm just a soul whose intentions are good. Oh Lord, please don't let me be misunderstood. You know, sometimes, baby, I'm so carefree with a joy that's hard to hide. And then sometimes again it seems that all I have is what.
What do you know about magic?
Fantasy books?
Bob McLean!